A very good day to you. I'm Hank Gross, MidHudsonNews.com. It's Friday, July 30th. The news today brought to you by the Galleria at Crystal Run. While the family of Danny Meyer, the 12-year-old Maybrook Little Leaguer who was murdered in 1996, awaits word on if his killer is granted parole, another family that went through the same trauma feels their pain. In 1973, Joan D'Alessandro of Hillsdale, New Jersey, went to a neighbor's house to sell Girl Scout cookies, and the high school chemistry teacher who lived there brutally murdered the child and dumped her body near Harriman State Park in Stony Point. Her mother, Rosemary, told Mid-Hudson News that it is pure torture for the mother to relive the horror of the event when a parole hearing comes up every 2 years.
She's not free for 2 years. If she's free 6 months, depends upon the person. You know, she'll have 6 months. Then she goes through it again. So it's almost like what you're doing is psychological torture.
For the D'Alessandro family, that part of their journey is over. Joan's killer, Joseph McGowan, died in prison this past June. She plans to convey her thoughts to the New York State Parole Board in hopes of convincing its members not to grant parole to Juan Pinato, Danny Meyer's killer. Orange County Democratic Party Chairman Brett Brogy has called on Republican State Assemblyman Colin Schmidt to stand with cops and denounce the radical QAnon House Republicans, his words. Brogy's comments followed this week's testimony before a House Investigations Committee into the January 6th insurrection, where police who were beaten and injured defending the Capitol testified about their ordeal. At the same time, Trump-supporting Republican House members downplayed the attack. Schmidt is the announced GOP candidate challenging Democratic Representative Sean Patrick Maloney in the next congressional election. Brogy says Schmidt, in his words, cheered on a busload of protesters going to the Stop the Steal rally in Washington. But Schmidt spokesman Taylor Wyaneth, meanwhile, called the assemblyman, in his words, the most vocal advocate for law enforcement in the Hudson Valley. More news right after this.
The new school year is right around the corner, and the Galleria at Crystal Run in Middletown is the ultimate destination for your back-to-school essentials. Shop the latest fashions from American Eagle, Champs, DSW, Forever 21, Hollister, Journeys, and more. Visit GalleriaCrystalRun.com for a complete list of deals for students and teachers. The Galleria at Crystal Run, your back-to-school shopping headquarters.
The Preservation League of New York State and their program partners at the New York State Council on the Arts have announced their Preserve New York grantees for this year. In Orange County, the Chester Historical Society will receive $5,200. A 63-year-old Town of Monroe man was killed in a two-car crash on Old Route 17 in the town of Tuxedo early in the morning of Wednesday, state police report. Police said 31-year-old Eliezer Sibler of Monroe was driving a box truck northbound on Route 17, and a 2015 Nissan Sentra driven by Michael Waka, who was 63 of Monroe, was traveling southbound when they collided just south of Warwick Brook Road. Waka was trapped in his car and had to be extricated. He was pronounced dead at the scene. Sibler suffered several non-life-threatening injuries. The investigation into the cause of the crash is continuing. Orange County is recognizing National Farmers Market Week, which runs through Saturday, August 7th. Buying products from any of our great community markets is a wonderful way to support our local agricultural industry, says County Executive Stephen Newhouse. I'm Hank Gross, MidHudsonNews.com. The news brought to you today by the Galleria at Crystal Run.